Monica, I am in the class. Talk to me later on after 10 o'clock. So H11 can be written as HIE. Okay. Now H21 is what? With B2 short circuited or B2 is equal to 0. Output short circuit. I2 by I1 can be written as, see, look at I2 by I1 can be written as I prime by I1 into I2 by I prime. Okay. And we see that I prime by I1 is nothing but HFE. HFE. First stage is emitter configuration. So its current gain is HFE. And minus sign is coming because of the current direction. See, the current direction shown in different way. Okay. And I prime HFB equals to HFE. Why this is written? Because we know that minus HFB is almost equal to 1. See here this value from this table. Minus HFB almost equals to 1. So this equals to this we are writing. Understood this one, Pratham?
Yes, sir.
And this alpha is sometimes called alpha is C alpha. It's called C common emitter alpha is shown here. Now next is H22, which is I2 by V2. I2 by V2. I2 by V2 is what? I2 by V2 is HO or what?
Output conductance.
Output conductance with inputs. Input what? Open?
Yes, sir. With input open circuit.
Open. I1 open means I1 no current. No current is when it is open. Okay. So if I1 is 0, the output resistance of Q1 is equal to 1 upon HOE equals to 40 kilo ohm. If you see the table, this table or this table in EDC, then you will see that it is 40 kilo ohm. We have already studied this thing. Hence, the equivalent source resistance for Q2, this is output resistance. Remember, 1 upon HOE is the output resistance of first stage, which is CE. Okay, CE stage. Its output resistance is nothing but the source for the second stage. Do you agree or not?
Yes, sir.
As good as it is going to behave. First stage is going to behave as the source for the second stage. This resistance is going to be 40 kilo ohm. So now, I'm going to discuss about other thing. H22 equals to 1 upon HO, sorry, RO equals to this. We know that HOB. Okay. Now, H12, P1 by V2. H12 equals to B1 by V2. When I1 equals to 0 means input is open circuited. B1 by V2. Okay. So B1 by V2. V1 here and V2 is here. Can be written as B1 by V prime into V prime by V2 equals to this thing. Can you write or not? B1 by V2 is what? B1 by V2 is reverse transfer. voltage gain or not? Input by output voltage, no? Output by input is the gain, but voltage gain. But input by input voltage by output voltage is reverse voltage gain. Okay. So this is HRE because it is common emitter configuration. It is HRB because here also input voltage is B prime, output voltage is V2. The definition is understood. We have discussed earlier, so I think it's not difficult. Now, it is summarized here. Everything is summarized. HI equals to H11 equals to HI. It is nothing but 1100 ohm. And you can see from the table we have discussed earlier. Then HF equals to H21 equals to almost equals to HF is current gain or not? We have just seen the equations earlier. That is about 49 equals to almost equals to HF E. Okay, closer to HFE. And now HO equals to H22 equals to 0.49 microampere per volt, which is almost equals to HOB. See, HOB. HOB, right? And HR equals to this. How it is coming? See, last we saw that HRE multiplied by HRB. HRE is this one. This one is HRE multiplied by RB. Multiply this, you will get this value, 7.25 into 10 to the power minus 8. Is it coming or not? Here it has been summarized, and I hope if you multiply, you get same value, 7.25 into 10 to the power minus 8, or it is equal to HRE, HRB. Okay, so now let us conclude about this results. Note that the input resistance and the current gain, that is this two thing. Let me this two thing gain are nominally equal to the corresponding parameter values for the single C stage, isn't it? We are writing HIE, HFE. We are able to write that. And for that, we have seen the reason. The output resistance, that is 1 upon HO. Okay. Output resistance is approximately equal to the CV value. That's what we have seen here. Okay. That is 2 mega ohm. You see, they are writing C 1 upon HOE if you do, because HO you have got as HOB, so 1 upon that is going to be almost 2.04 ohm, mega ohm. Okay, which is much higher than the C stage. Single, instead of using single stage, we are getting very high output resistance. It was 40 kilo ohm. It is 40 kilo ohm versus 2 mega ohm. It's too high. Okay. The reverse, most important thing is here, the reverse open circuit amplification parameter HR is very much smaller. Very much. HR, this one. It is a multiplication of this 2. Individually, it was how much? It was 2.5 into 10 to the minus 4. And this was CV was 2.9 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay. But it is now multiplication of this 2, which gives you 7.25 into 10 to the power minus 8. Remember, 10 to the power minus 8. It is so less or negligible. Okay. So it is very much smaller for the cascade connection, and it is important. Why it is important? We'll come to know here. The small value of HR of this combination for the cascade transistor, PR makes this circuit particularly useful in tuned amplifier, a kind of amplifier we have to study in future. Okay, that will require very low HR. Output voltage should not be able to affect the input. That is the main idea. Okay, should be as minimum as possible. Okay, for tuned amplifier, reduction in the internal feedback. It is kind of amplifier's own feedback. Output is feeding back to the input. That is not desirable. So, in tuned amplifier, this will be used extensively. This kind of cascade amplifier will be used in tuned amplifier. Okay. So, the reduction of the internal feedback of the compound device reduces the probability of oscillation and results in an improved stability of the circuit. Okay. So, that's the reason it is important. So, most important part is this one. The reverse voltage gain is less, very less. Okay. Along with other things, it is also one of the important things, which is going to provide the stability and no oscillation. Now, we'll start calculation of common collector configuration. Okay. Very simple calculations we have to do. In this figure 8-5, at the bottom one, common collector is the top one, bottom one is the common collector. The figure is a little different. I mean, different in the sense, first one is common collector configuration with PNP BJT, and it is the bottom one is the simplified hybrid pi model, hybrid model. Okay, same circuit, only thing representation is different. Okay, representation is different. Small signal representation this is, and with the various parameters we have studied. Let us now see its current gain. You see the current, note that IE is output or load current, output or load current. It is in this way. Load has been connected here at the emitter terminal. And it is also called what? Tell me, this configuration CC is also called what? Tell what it is called? Tell CC is also called something. Who is that? Aman is there? Or any other boys? Pratham, you are not able to remember? Bushra Akhtar? Astipati?
Sir, emitter follower.
Yes, it is emitter follower. Good. Emitter follower. Gain is what of this configuration? Less than one, less than unity. Just now we are discussing. So anyway, current gain, let us see. Current gain will be output current divided by the IV, input current. So IE, as you can see the direction of the current, so minus sign is given, is what? Current at this junction is what? These two current, IE, see that? IE is what? It is IB plus HAP IB or not? IE, if you look at this junction and the bottom circuit, IB plus this HFE is one current component in this direction, one is in this direction. The summation of these two, HFEIB, Okay, so it becomes IB. If you take common, it becomes what? 1 plus HFE or not? So we have written this. It is correct. And so this gets cancelled and we get this one. AI equals to 1 plus HFE. In this small signal representation, current gain, could you understand, Pratham?
Yes, sir.
This equation we have brought back from earlier discussion, and hence we get this. Comparing this equation with the exact expression 840, we conclude that when the simplified equivalent circuit of 25, and this one, is used, the current gain is overestimated by less than 10%. If HOERL less than 0.1, I mean to say this RL is also taken into account. Input resistance of this CC. Input resistance of CC. Is it understandable? C? Are you getting or not? Input resistance, obviously, input voltage by input current. And input voltage can be written as what? HIE plus IB. See, from table 8.3, we have seen that it is HIC equals to HIE. That's why you are writing HIE term. This term is coming because of that. So HIE IB. HIEIB, this one, a voltage plus 1 plus HFEIBRL divided by IB. So BB equals to this or not?
Yes, sir.
So we get RI equals to HIE. Because this gets cancelled, no? 1 plus HFE into RL. Okay. So RI of this configuration in a small signal hybrid model, we write RI equals to HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RL. See, we cannot ignore anything whatever we have discussed. If you don't remember or try to remember this, it will be difficult. Okay, so previous equations I am writing here so that it becomes easier for us to further discuss. These all equations you have seen recently or earlier. Okay. So note that RI is much greater than 1 kilo ohm, even if RL is as small as 0.5 kilo ohm, because HFE is greater than much greater than 1. So do you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
So if we substitute from equation and this fifth equation 54 8.54 into exact expression 41, we obtain the 55 equation. This, however, we have just concluded that equation 8-54 gives too high a value of AI by at most 10%. Hence, it follows that RI as calculated from 8-55 or 8-25 is also overestimated by less than 10%. Voltage gain. Voltage gain equation AV equals to 1 minus HIE by RI has been taken and discussed earlier. So we have shown here as a reference, the voltage gain of the emitter follower is close to unity. We have seen that. And is given by this equation, or 1 minus AV equals to HI by RI. Input resistance. HI is what? HI is what parameter?
Input resistance and output is short circuit.
So this same equation is actually written in a different way. Okay. If, for example, RI equals to 10 HIE, then AV equals to 0.9. If, however, we use an approximate value of RI, which is 10% too high, then HIE RIE equals to 1 by 11 equals to 0.09. and AV equals to 0.91. Hence, the approximate calculation for AV gives the value which is only 1% too high. I mean to say it is closer to unity, that we have understood, but depending on the value of the factors like, you know, RL, etc., little bit of variation will come, less than 10% or so. Now, this equation of AV we have already brought earlier. Then this equation 836 we have seen earlier. Okay, this is nothing but your sample equations, I mean relations, Thevenin theorem, etc. We have discussed this thing also. Thevenin's theorem or that kind of Norton's theorem, etc. If you are remembering. And it is so simple. In figure, this figure, the open circuit output voltage is Vs. This is the Vs. And the short circuit output is given by this. Output current is given by this equation. Short circuit current will be given by this. 1 plus HFIB equals to 1 plus HFIBS by HIE plus RS, since IB equals to VS by IE plus RS. Yes or no? IB.
Yes, sir.
IB equals to VS divided by HIE plus RS. Okay. Hence, the output admittance of the transistor alone can be written as this, which is simplified to be, because this is getting cancelled, and you get 1 plus HFE by HIE RS. Okay. Should I continue? Okay, then we'll discuss next class. Next class. Okay, leave the class and do other classes.